Hello, I'm Adam, and I'll be guiding you through the process of adding contacts to your account today. Please note that the contact feature is exclusive to marketing plans. To begin, navigate to the Audience tab on the left sidebar. You will reach the main dashboard where you can find general information about your contacts. Our focus today will be on adding contacts, so click the Add Contacts button to reveal two options. You can either upload a prepared list of contacts by selecting Upload Contacts, or we can add contacts individually by choosing Add Contact. Let's start with the latter option. Even though it's simpler, it can be more time-consuming. Adding contacts individually is an easy process. Simply fill in the basic fields one by one. While it's not mandatory to provide all the information, the email address is the only required field. In the second step, you can specify the list that this contact should be included in. Initially, you can assign the contact to only one list, but you can later edit and assign it to multiple lists as well. Choose the proper status for the contact from five options: transactional, active, inactive, unsubscribed, or complaint. The status should be in line with the customer's preferences regarding the type of emails they wish to receive or their previous engagement with your emails. You can learn more about contact statuses here. If you have a user's consent and you want to send marketing campaigns, you should select active. The last section is related to contact permissions. Indicate whether the customer agreed to receive communications and allowed tracking. The selection of the don't know option is considered as permissions for tracking. You can then either add the contact and complete the process or select add another to repeat the process for additional individual contacts. We suggest using this option only when you need to add individual contacts. For example, your recent buyer in an offline shop. With a larger number of contacts, uploading the entire list is highly recommended. So now let's navigate to this option and add contacts in bulk. First of all, you have to confirm that your entire list consented to receive email communication. It's crucial to be in line with GDPR. Then you have three options: upload contacts from a file, type or copy and paste contacts, or import them from MailChimp. You can learn more about the last option here. For today, we'll focus on the recommended solution: uploading contacts from a file. There are many accepted file formats like ZIP or XML, but we recommend using .csv. Choose the file encoding, usually the default is the correct one, and upload the file. The file should be prepared in line with basic rules. First of all, an email field is mandatory. You must use this field written exactly like this. The CSV file format consists of values separated by a comma. In the description of this video, you'll find the link to our contact list example with correctly prepared data. In the CSV file, you can also include custom contact fields. This additional feature is a part of our Marketing Pro plan, providing the possibility to use an unlimited number of custom fields for recipients. This allows for enhanced personalization in your communication efforts and segmenting your contacts. When uploading, you can either upload the file from your computer or drag and drop it into this area. You'll receive information about the number of uploaded contacts and recognized contact fields. If you want to match the field data to an existing custom field, you can select it from the drop-down list here. With the Marketing Pro plan, you can also create new custom fields by selecting this option. If there are contacts in your file that already exist on your account, you can update all of them. In the last step, decide on the specific contact list for these contacts. Just like when adding individual contacts, you need to specify the contact status and tracking consent. Note that it won't overwrite the status of unsubscribed and complaint recipients that have already been on your account. When it's all done, click Continue, and you'll see a success screen with detailed information about added contacts, including active, invalid, and duplicated contacts. Those invalid and duplicated contacts are not counted in the total amount of contacts on your account. Please remember that processing contacts in the background might require some time, so there's no need to concern if you don't see all the contacts immediately. Once completed, you should be able to send emails to your new or updated contact list. And that's all for today. If you have any questions or problems related to adding contacts, don't hesitate to contact our customer support team. If you need any additional tutorials, please let us know in the comment section. We'll take it into consideration.